Interest areas are one of the cornerstones of the analysis of most eye tracking studies. To put it simply, an interest area defines a region of the screen that was shown during the experiment that is of interest for your data analysis. In a study on reading behavior, the interest areas might contain the individual words of the sentence. In a study on face perception, you might create interest areas around the different facial features, like the eyes, nose, and mouth. And in a study on saccadic eye movements, you might define an interest area around an initial point of fixation and a subsequent one around a target for a saccadic eye movement. The use of interest areas in DataViewer gives you the ability to output countless measures regarding the gaze patterns in relation to those areas. For the simplest example, once you have defined interest areas, you can easily output a report that tells you the total amount of time that the participant fixated on those interest areas for each trial of the experiment. In addition to this simple example of interest area dwell time, DataViewer's reports offer dozens of other ways of breaking down the eye movement data in relation to these interest areas. In this video, we'll talk about how to create and use static interest areas in DataViewer. For information on how to create dynamic interest areas, which can be useful for experiments involving moving stimuli, like videos, please see the other video in this tutorial series on dynamic interest areas. For this video, we'll focus on interest areas that don't change position within a trial. But please note that since static interest areas can have an onset time, you can easily use different sets of static interest areas for different interest periods within your trials. When working with interest areas, you first should ensure that you can see them by toggling interest area visibility on at the top of the DataViewer interface. This will make it so that you can see the interest areas of the experiment in the various views in the trial view window. Then, importantly, you should also make sure that you have set your interest period so that you're focusing on the relevant period of the trials in your experiment. Please see the previous video in this video tutorial series for information on setting an interest period. If your experimental program sent interest area information to the EDF file, then you should see your interest areas in the spatial overlay view of the trial view window when interest area visibility is turned on. For example, if you ran your experiment using Experiment Builder and you had interest area information programmed into your experiment, then the interest area information would automatically be sent to the EDF file, and you should see the interest areas now. If your study was a reading study that was programmed in Experiment Builder, then the segmentation of the text into interest areas would depend upon the settings in the preferences of that Experiment Builder project. By default, Experiment Builder segments text into interest areas based on the space character, but it can be configured to be based on the phrase or even character level of the text. If you used another programming environment like Psych Toolbox, ePrime, Presentation, PsychoPy, or other tools to run your iLink experiment and it sent special interest area messages to the EDF file, then you should also see them now. For more information on the formatting of these messages, you can check out the DataViewer user manual, which you can access by clicking Help, Contents. The manual has a section called Protocol for iLink Data to Viewer Integration, which has a subsection on interest area commands. If you'd like to create new interest areas, then you can use the interest area tools at the top of the trial view window. It's easiest to create static interest areas when in the spatial overlay view, so you can first make sure that you're in that view. Once you've done that, you can select a trial and then use the tools to draw the interest areas. Each time you create an interest area, you can give it a label and click Enter to create it. Now's a good time to mention that though you can create interest areas for each trial one by one, that's often not the fastest way to do things. For many studies, the interest areas might need to be similar for all trials that fall within a certain condition or group. For these cases, it's much faster to draw the interest areas for one representative trial in that condition or group, and then automatically apply that set of interest areas to all other trials in the group. Let's talk about how you can do this. First, You want to make sure that the data are grouped by a trial variable that identifies groups of trials that should have a common interest area set. Please see the video on trial variables and trial grouping in this video series for more information on variables and grouping. In this viewing session from a simple experiment that presented a different image on each trial, I have a variable called ImageFile, and this variable's value for each trial identifies the image file that was used for that trial. So I can go back to Edit, Trial Grouping, and regroup the data by this image file variable. Now the data are grouped by this variable in the inspector. For each of these groups of trials, we can set up the interest areas once and apply that set of interest areas to all trials in the group. I'll show you how. First, I'll select one of the trials in the first group of trials. Since our interest period has been set, and since this project was programmed in Experiment Builder, which automatically sends trial information to the EDF file, we'll be able to see the trial stimulus as the background. I'll make sure that the visibility of interest areas is turned on and the visibility of all the eye data is turned off. This just allows us to focus on the interest area creation without distraction or interference from the eye data's presence in the trial view window. Now you can use the interest area drawing tools to draw the interest areas where you'd like them to be. There are three types of drawing tools: rectangle, ellipse, and freehand. If you need to edit an interest area after it's been created, you can choose the Select tool and then hold the Alt key. While holding the Alt key, click and drag an edge or corner of that interest area. Alternatively, if you want to specify precise values for the boundaries of an interest area, you can select the interest area and edit its properties in the inspector. Also, there are some really useful interest area editing tools that can be accessed by selecting one or more interest areas and then right-clicking and going to IA Shape Actions. You can copy and paste interest areas within and across trials too. So if your interest areas have some common features, then the combination of copying and pasting and using these editing options makes interest area creation a quick and easy process. Once the interest areas have been properly created for that one trial in the group, you can save that interest area set to disk using this button at the top of the trial view window. When you do so, you'll be asked whether you want to add the interest area file to the viewing session as a template. If you choose yes, then you'll be able to see the template in the inspector under the Interest Area Templates section. And importantly, adding the interest area set as a template allows you to apply that set to other trials or groups of trials. To do so, you can just select the trial grouping value that this trial belongs to and choose this template as the group's default interest area set. After doing so, you'll be able to see that the interest area has been applied to all trials in that group by selecting other trials in the group in the inspector. Note, when you save IAS files, you are actually just saving a text file that contains the interest area information. I'll open the file that I just saved using a text editor so that you can see its contents. Rectangle and ellipse interest areas have an ID value, a left, top, right, and bottom boundary in pixels, and a label. Freehand interest areas have an ID value, a list of points that, when connected, define the boundaries of the interest area, and a label. If you'd like to create your own interest area files, you can read more about the required formatting of these files in the section of the Data Viewer User Manual, Working with Events, Samples, and Interest Areas, Interest Areas. If you'd like to import an interest area set file, like one from another viewing session or one that you've created yourself as a template, you can use the File, Import Data, Interest Area Template command. Interest areas can be dynamic too, but we'll save the discussion of that for the next video in this series.